happy Valentine's to you. Today everything is all red. I'm in red, my lipstick is red, my drink is orange. Let me sip it and then we get started, okay? So today we really have a fun video. I'm excited to do this kind of video because I've never done it before, but I thought, hey, it's Valentine's, so let me put up something together and then let's see what we can achieve to celebrate this day. I know some people do celebrate it, some don't. Some love being gifted, others don't like to. So I think it's more of a personal thing. And if you're married, I think it's more of a couple thing and what you decide as a couple. For example, I know couples who decide to go all the way and celebrate, and I know some who don't. However, it doesn't mean if you're single, you should not do anything, okay? If you are into Valentine's, hey, go celebrate yourself. Why not, all right? So I'm here to give you 10 fun ideas that you can do for Valentine's, all right? And some will be a bit favored because I live in Mombasa, so I'll probably be using examples here in Mombasa. But don't worry, wherever you are, I'm sure you can get somewhere to go and do the things I'll be talking about, right? So let's get started. So the first idea that I have, okay, is dinner, right? There are so many ways of doing this. You can choose to go out for the dinner. You can choose to make a special dinner at your home. You can choose to order in. So if you live in Mombasa, there are several places I can think of right off the top of my mind. There's Forodhani. I love Forodhani. I think the view is amazing. If you want, and Forodhani is quite affordable. Right, number two, there are more expensive places. There's places like White Sands, Braden, there's Maasai, there's Chachoma. There are so many places you can actually visit. You can even go to Java. Can go to Crave. Hey, you can even go to Mama City, kwa Kibanda. It doesn't matter as long as it's where you enjoy. And Mama City is actually Kibanda fancy, okay? We go there all the time. So it depends where you want to go. Do you want to go high-end restaurants or do you want to go kawaida place or your nyam chom, your local karibu or something? It doesn't matter. Another option that you have is you can choose to have a dinner in your house. Make something special. I remember when my firstborn was 2 years. So my best friend and I at that time were neighbors. So we decided we wanted to do something for our husbands and actually celebrate. And we were both stay-at-home moms. So like it doesn't matter that we stay home. We want to do something special for our husbands. So we started planning like a couple of weeks before. So we came up with a menu. I remember we did roasted rosemary chicken, potato skin. Yeah, there were potato skins. And then we did with cheese and bacon. And then we did a salad on the side. We then baked a red velvet cake with vanilla ice cream. It slapped. And I remember when our husbands walked back home and they were surprised because first of all, we were all dressed up. Our babies were looking really cute and we were ready for the dinner. And I don't know why they had not bought any gifts, and I remember they just left, they rushed and then they bought us gifts, and we had one of the most incredible dinners we had. And it was simple, but it was candlelit at home. It was a three-course meal and it was beautiful. So you don't have to go outside and spend. You can decide to do something like that at home for your loved one. It can even be for your kids, it can be for your spouse, it can be for yourself, for your parents, whoever it is that you wish to celebrate on that day. So don't limit yourself or say you don't have the money, okay? Gotta sip my drink, right? Yo, I was feeling so special for you guys. I even did a wine glass. Don't do wine in this house, so this is juice, so I can just hold it there and make my nails look cute. So my next point is movie night. Number two, you can do a movie night, okay? Okay. And those are easy. You can find a favorite movie that you love. Like, I'm a fan of beautiful romantic love movies. If you do have Netflix, I'm sure they'll have a lot of movies which are released this week, which are love movies, or whatever that you guys enjoy. Maybe it's even a reality show or whatever. You can decide to go with that and watch that. You can set up like snacks and do like popcorns at home, add some butter, or do caramel if that's what you like. do some drinks. It can be soda. It can be fresh juice. Get some cake, pour some yogurt on it, or serve it with ice cream. You can also do chips. Like right now, I'm having these tortilla chips, right? For Ola. You can grab some of these. They are really nice. These ones, and they have different flavors. And this is not sponsored, by the way. I just like them. You can make like nachos out of them. You can. And just have fun, right? And have a wonderful Valentine's at low cost. Small cost, actually. That's a game night, okay? You can also decide to celebrate your Valentine's by having a game night. We've tried it in my family here. I know sometimes these things don't sound so African, but they are. We just choose not to do them, okay? Maybe the way we were brought up, but you can change the narrative, right? So you can select which game your family prefers. So there's like chess, Monopoly, there's Jenga, there's draft, there's snake and ladder. I remember one time my family, we actually played snake and ladder, and it was pretty intense, okay? So you can choose to do that for Valentine's. So you can set up snacks that you can have. You can do milkshakes, smoothies, whatever that your family likes, and enjoy a fun game night. And to even make it more fun, you can have rewards for people who score better, and just have fun and incorporate everyone in your family, from the youngest to the oldest to the parents. It can even be a game night with your friends. Do something. Go play some games, okay? Another fun idea is massages and spas. Who doesn't like to get massaged? Who doesn't get like spas? Those are fun. So in Mombasa, since I live in Mombasa, there are fun places you can go for massages and spas. We have like Pride Inn, we have White Sands, we have Travelers. There's a place in Nyali that I know, I think it's around 3,000 per person, that you can get a wonderful massage, though that's for women only. But there are other places where you can go, whether you're a female or a male, they don't care, whoever you are, you can go get a good massage. Or you can pay for someone that you love, your parent, you can pay for your spouse, and go have fun. So just think of an area where you can go and get it, and you feel more relaxed. Your body will thank you for it. You're going to enjoy it, and it's actually a very thoughtful Valentine's gift. So go ahead and look for one in your area, okay? Hey, by the way, you can gift me that one if you want to. I wouldn't mind, okay? Would you some massage? All right, guys, too much foolery, okay? Too much foolery. We gotta be ourselves. The next one I have is you can write a letter. I love when my kids go to school and they come back with this letter, like happy Valentine's mom, dear mom, and they're appreciating you in like a note, and it's really, really cute and means a lot to me. So you can do that for the person that you love. You can even write a letter to yourself. How many times do you sit down and say, I'm gonna write a letter to myself and appreciate who you are, and just love on yourself? You can do that for someone else and just appreciate them. Let them know what they mean to you and how much you appreciate them. Be grateful, like our last video that we said, you know, let them know that you're grateful they're here with you. Just love on that person and make them feel special on this day. And that won't cost much, right? But it will bring so much joy to that person, and especially because these are words from your heart and you really mean them. So that's another more affordable way that you can do that and celebrate that person on Valentine's. So don't say you don't know what to do or what to write. Okay, guys, buy flowers. I love flowers, okay? I love them, and I love buying myself flowers. I buy myself flowers, and I love having them here. Like you guys saw, I had some dried eucalyptus. So sometimes I do that, or sometimes I'll get roses. The other time I got birds of paradise. So you can go and buy the person you love flowers, or the person that you want to appreciate, even for your kids. I remember one of the years, my brother bought for all our girls. He bought them chocolate and a rose flower, and he went to school and gave all the girls, and it was really, really beautiful. My family, we have a lot of girls, and that was really special for them. And my daughter was even reminding me of when the dad did that, Baba Mdogo, or the uncle, and it was such a special moment. So you can go and bless someone with a bouquet of flowers. It can be a single flower, it can be whatever. And in Mombasa, I know several places where you can get flowers, but the people I get from, I have Kazungu. He's based at Cool Beans. I'll leave his number here. You can call him and he'll organize and deliver to you at a fee, or you can go and pick it up. It's at opposite tree at Cool Beans, where there's the Shell petrol station. He's there. I do have Gabriel, who is opposite, directly opposite Saving Home. He's right outside next to the old Super Cosmetics. You'll get in there. You can go and get, and a single rose is like 50 bob. Okay, maybe today it's gonna be 100 because it's Valentine's. But hey, imagine what it will do to that person who really appreciates flowers. So go grab them, and you can just add like a chocolate there. It'll mean a lot, and it doesn't cost much. So number 7 is buy a gift. I know some people think like it's all about consumerism and just buying stuff and any, but hey, kwani where is the harm if you buy someone a gift on Valentine's Day? So find what the person would like to appreciate likes. Maybe it's a handbag, maybe it's wool, maybe it's whatever gift. And there's so many places. There are supermarkets like Naivas, Carrefour, there are places like Saving Home. They have really cute gift ideas. It's at Naivas Center, where there's Nyali. You can go and get something from there. The other beautiful place, you have Miniso. There's some several gift shops at City Mall that you can go and get something. So I don't think we really have an excuse as to why we can't buy a gift. And it doesn't have to be expensive. It can range from as little as you have to the most expensive thing you could have. Okay, maybe you want to take me to Maldives. Okay, so gift yourself, do something for yourself. Like, I'm gonna gift myself tomorrow. I will. I'll get something for myself. I love hot cocoa, so maybe I'll go buy myself hot cocoa, celebrate Valentine's. I'll show you guys, okay? Go get a gift. It's really nice. Go dancing. My husband and I, when we were not really dating, but back then we used to dance salsa. So it would be a beautiful thing to decide to start dancing salsa again, right? So there are several places you can go to and attend some dancing classes. I know in Nairobi there is a place at Art Cafe where guys go, and in Mombasa I know there are also places you can go and dance. So you just need to sign up for a class, and I'm sure tomorrow there are probably restaurants that are gonna be offering that, or maybe they'll have live bands with dinner and you can dance afterwards and just enjoy a good time. You're single, you don't have to stay home, you can go dancing alone, right? Enjoy yourself. Go dancing. Another fun one is that you can bake together, okay? You can choose to bake with your kids, you can do cookies, to brownies, to cakes, all right? I'm a baker, I was gonna talk about cake anyway. You can do cupcakes, and some of the really nice romantic cakes that you can do is like red velvet or cheesecake. You also have chocolate cake, and I do have recipes for that on my channel, so I'll link up those videos. I even have the ones for decorating. You can choose to do cupcakes or a block cake, whatever works for your family and what you enjoy, and you can serve it with ice cream or some juice or some milkshake and have fun. Especially the decorating and the mixing and the whole process is so rewarding and so much fun. So pick one and do it, and let me know which cake you'd like to choose. And since this video will be up in the morning, if there's a recipe you'd like, just DM me and I'm gonna text you on what to do and the steps to follow, so you can have a lovely cake for your Valentine's. Just like I told you guys, we baked a red velvet cake and we served it with vanilla ice cream, and it was really, really nice. All right, so now guys, we're on the last one. Okay, I'm sure there are more than 10 ideas to do. You can travel together, you can go on holiday together, you can do whatever, you can be spontaneous. But the last one that I really wanted to talk about is volunteering together. You can decide to go to a children's home, you can decide to go to the needy, you can decide to go to a needy family and just go be with them and love on them this Valentine's Day. You can buy, the economy is really hard right now, so you can decide to do some shopping, maybe a packet of flour, a packet of sugar, some rice, some cooking oil, just go visit them and say, hey, I would like for you guys to have a wonderful dinner today and actually celebrate Valentine's and know that you are loved and God loves you above all. And what a beautiful Valentine's, right? And that will be so selfless because you're not thinking about yourself. You're going out and doing for others. It doesn't mean it's bad to do it for yourself, but you're going out and doing something that blesses other people. You could do it alone. You could do it with your spouse. Do it as your whole family, as a church. You can do it however you'd wish to, okay? So there are different ways of doing this. So go and do something positive today.